You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible.
If y'all, I just saw this and I just can't. Y'all roll it.
Why? I got you.
Illegally selling water without a permit on my property.
Whoa!
Hey! Hey, give me your ID.
You don't live here.
I'm
comfortable. So our segment is called Crazy as White People. In Illinois, Lauren Underwood was the incumbent. Tough race against millionaire Jim Oberweis. Y'all, 2 days ago, the race was called for Lauren Underwood. Sister, just finished her first term in Congress. Amisha, her opponent, this fool, showed up to freshman orientation. y'all heard me right. Please go to my iPad. This is a tweet. Somebody says, oh my God, Jim Oberweis, who tried to claim victory when there were still 20,000 uncounted ballots that ultimately lost to Representative Underwood, just showed up for a new member orientation. Player, you didn't win. That's some white privilege right there for your ass to show up to new member orientation. I guess he had some extra time. He just wanted to hang out because your ass ain't a new member. You lost.
So I'm an Illinois resident, and this is not my first time around the block seeing Oberweis, who is a millionaire who owns his own dairy farms and, you know, all kinds of ice cream and other stuff. Oberweis, this is about his ninth time in 6 years running for something and getting mollywopped in a race. So, you know, Illinois knows Oberweis well because he likes to run and never win. And in this case, because he saw what he thought was a window of opportunity in the Underwood race, where you have this black woman who didn't, in my opinion, did not get as much credibility as she should have during the midterms, because she literally flipped a historically red seat, a red district in Illinois, blue. And that is something that is a huge deal, because outside of the Chicagoland area, the majority of Illinois is red. It just is what it is. So this young woman who comes in, she's stellar. She's literally a policy wonk. She's a health leader and educator. And you know, on the wings of a pandemic, really soared in that sense as well. You have this privileged white guy come through. And mind you, again, as an Illinois resident, I've seen him come through before. He's the guy who will bring chicken on 79th Street to give to the black people so that they will get out and vote for him. That is Oberweis. And this go round, he had so much faith that he was actually going to unseat her. Republicans really funneled a lot of money into that seat because they wanted to see her gone. And push comes to shove on election day, it all fell apart. I think that what we're seeing in Oberweis is someone who wants to be Trumpian but doesn't have the gall or the people behind him to actually do it. He's somebody who doesn't want to admit defeat, which he should be used to because, hell, the man's been getting defeated for the past 10 years. He runs literally in every election.
Garrett, that's peak whiteness right there.
You know, the real question is, did the people let him sit in?
The Republicans, yeah.
Did the people let him sit in? Because if you lost, cuz, you got to go home. You ain't got to go home, but you can't be here because you didn't win the election. But I think that this is a window into the impact of Trump as well, right? You got a president who's refusing to concede. He's confused. He's refusing to admit that he's lost, right? And so here his homeboy, another rich white man, said, look, cuz, I'm coming. I'm coming through. I'm pulling up. And if the sisters say he runs over and over again and he's an older white man, what we see is another old white man who's just trying to say, I can't let go. This is my time. This is my opportunity. He has wanted so long, clearly, to be elected, and now he feels like he's got this opportunity. Cuz just said, let me come to the orientation at least. Just let me come through to the orientation at least.
Michael, that's just hilarious that you just going to think you're just going to roll up there in orientation. Dog, you ain't win, man. You ain't win. You ain't win, you lost. And so you're not going to get assigned to office. But I guess he has stuff to do for a couple of days.
Well, brother, you know, this is an example of white privilege. Now, what do you think would have happened if a brother or sister showed up and they didn't win and they said they want to sit in on freshman orientation? But my question is, for the Republicans for freshman orientation, did they wear masks? That's what I want to know.
Well, you know, well, they've been talking about that. And one of the things that that crazy fool out of Georgia, she said she stood up in the caucus and was like, this is about being freedom. Why are we all having to wear masks? But her ass wore masks walking in there.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, once again, brother, this is we see things like this. This reminds me of when Governor of Florida, the one before Ron DeSantis, and he ran for senator, and the race had not been called yet, okay, and he showed up to the Senate orientation. Now he ended up winning, okay. This was in the 2018 midterm election, okay. I forgot what was the previous governor's name in Florida.
Scott was now in the Senate.
Yeah. So Scott ran for senator, defeated the Democrat. But when he showed up to the Senate for orientation, the race had not been called yet. Okay. But he showed up anyway. All right. And they let him sit in. Okay. So, you know, brother, you know, watch whiteness works. We've seen this before.
All right, folks, back to my uncle's video in just one moment.
It's time to be smart. When we control our institutions, we win.
We win.
This is the most important news show on television of any racial background. Y'all put $2, $3, $4, $5, $10, $15, $20, $30 on this and keep this going. What you've done, Roland, since this crisis came out in full bloom. Anybody watching this, tell your friends, go back and look at the last 2 weeks, especially of Roland Martin Unfiltered. I mean, hell, go back and look at the last 2 days. You've had sitting United States Senators today, Klobuchar and Harris. Whatever you have that you have, you can bring to Roland Martin Unfiltered to support it. Please do, because this information may literally save your life.
Watch Roland Martin Unfiltered daily at 6 p.m. Eastern on YouTube, Facebook, or Periscope, or go to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered Daily Digital Show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. Our goal is to get 20,000 of our fans contributing $50 each for the whole year. You can make this possible. RolandMartinUnfiltered.com.